everyone, myself Sudhir Gupta, teacher at Study Hall Lucknow. I found YouTube as a platform to share my knowledge to students. So please like, share and subscribe my channel School Jaisa. And yes, don't forget to press the bell icon so that you could be able to see my all video updates. Thank you. Continuing with the same lesson, hydrogen chloride of class 10 ICSE. This is the third part of this topic. Here we should know also about the effect of the different indicator. So we see over here, I mentioned that HCl can turn the blue litmus paper and solution as red. HCl being an acidic gas, it can turn the methyl orange pink and phenolphthalein as colorless. What it means, that is phenolphthalein is colorless liquid, that is just like the water, and when you add the acid HCl in it, you will observe that no change, that means it remains colorless. Now one my question is over here. Suppose that a teacher asks you to add a little bit amount of the HCl in phenolphthalein, and she said, what will be your observation? So simply you will say that observation is that it remains colorless. Now the question comes, if it remains colorless, so teacher can say this also, that maybe you don't have added the HCl. How so? How do we get it confirmed that either the HCl has been added into it or not? So better with this, in order to know this, that we should add little bit alkaline KMnO4 potassium permanganate in phenolphthalein, due to which its color initially will be pink / purple. Now when you will add the HCl in it, you will observe that it become colorless. So it making a kind of a confirmation that HCl has been added into the phenolphthalein. Now we should know the next thing, how will you test the HCl gas? HCl gas can be tested by taking a glass rod and dipped in the ammonia solution. As soon as it brought in contact with HCl, we will observe dense white fumes of ammonium chloride. Dense white fumes, and that dense white fume will be of ammonium chloride. And one more thing you should know, that it is solid sublimable substance. You know meaning of solid sublimable substance? Sublimation. Okay. This is the one way to test HCl. Second, when AgNO3 is added to HCl, or when HCl is added to AgNO3 solution, we will observe curdy white PTT of HCl. This is the another way to understand that the gas which has been added to AgNO3 solution is HCl. Number 3, using lead nitrate solution, if we add HCl gas in lead nitrate solution, we will get white PPT of PbCl2, and one thing more, this is the white PPT which is soluble in hot water, insoluble in cold water, insoluble in cold water. And many more ways are to test the HCl. These are the main three you have to keep it in your mind. So what kind of the question can be asked over here? The question can be asked like this, what will be your observation when HCl is added to A part NH3, B part AgNO3, C part lead nitrate. So your observation will be when HCl is added to NH3, it gives dense white fume. When HCl is added to AgNO3, it gives curdy white PPT of AgCl. And when HCl is added to lead nitrate, it gives the white PPT of PbCl2. And here you have to keep it in mind that I told that it is soluble in hot water, insoluble in cold water. So one more question can be asked like this: name the salt which is soluble in hot water, insoluble in cold water, that is PbCl2. They can ask you the reaction also, that this much portion, those both reactants are given and you have to complete it. A question can be asked like this: write the reaction of this and this, this and this, this and this also. So this is the way to test the HCl gas.